So you know me, I'm an Ancap Cat, yeah. But I wasn't always this way. Really, I wasn't. From like elementary school to kind of early high school, I was once a liberal. Well, to back up a bit, before I became an ANCAP, I was a libertarian, and before that, I was a liberal. Yeah, quite different. So how was I a liberal? Well, here are some examples. I once supported the war on drugs. Yeah, the war, a pointless war that throws people in jail just for putting what they want to their bodies, or even just possessing what they could put in their bodies. At least to a violent black market as well as a huge bloated police state, an expensive police state. I wouldn't support that. If all these don't do drug classes in like science class, you know, presentations, I was convinced that the war on drugs was the way to go to arrest these drug dealers and to arrest these drug users. I also agreed with gun control. And, you know, I thought, oh, look at these big bad guns. They're so powerful, people shouldn't be able to have those. At least those kind of guns, maybe minor guns. And I remember going to an airport one time to like go to Florida or something, and I saw some instructions, you know, on a stand somewhere about how to bring firearms on a plane, you know, legally. And I got kind of spooked by that and a bit miffed. It's like, you can carry guns on a plane? I was kind of like that. I thought that was horrible. I also thought that the government should even have a say in how you eat. Like, they should make it illegal for a fast food joint to serve a person that's overweight. That they should have to do a check to make sure they're not too fat to be served, like, step on a scale or have a machine measure their width. You know, yeah, really, really cringy on my part for once thinking that way, but thank God I don't think that way anymore. Okay, so how did I go over to libertarianism? I went supporting the Iraq War, by the way. Well, I started doing my research for one. When I was in high school, I started doing my research on gun control and how it didn't work. I started doing some research on the war on drugs and how that didn't work. No, that only made me partially disagree with the war on drugs at that point so far. And as for the fast food thing, well, I guess I kind of dropped that a while back, you know, because that's just ridiculous. If a person wants to eat there, let them eat there. So I kind of, I don't know, I babbled on to a teacher about my political beliefs and Mr. Carroll, and he said I seemed like a libertarian, which I thought was interesting because I didn't quite like the libertarians. I thought they were all wild and didn't want to help anybody and stuff like that. But since he told me about I'm a libertarian, that's the kind of thing they believe in, and did my research and found out he was right, I discovered, hey, I'm a libertarian, so I support minimal government. So, how exactly did I partially disagree with the war on drugs, but not completely? Well, here's what I thought should happen. I thought it should be legal to farm drugs in the wild, you know, harvest them, like pick them off a plant, and of course use them, but I still thought it should be illegal to sell them, like sell and buy or, you know, sell them, whatever. I didn't think a business with narcotics should be legal. So I tell a friend this, and he snaps at me. He says, why the hell not? Like, he disagreed with the war on drugs completely, and when he heard I partially disagree with the war on drugs, he snapped at me. He's like, well, why the hell not? Like, why shouldn't people be allowed to sell these drugs? And by the way he snapped at me, I thought, hey, maybe I'm being a dumbass. Maybe I'm not looking into this hard enough to only partially disagree with the war on drugs, but not completely. So I did my research and found out, hey, the war on drugs should be disagreed with completely. So I did. I think people should not only be allowed to farm the drugs for a while, but I think they should be allowed to sell them too. Buy, sell, whatever you do with the drug, as long as you aren't hurting anyone other than yourself, if even you are being hurt, then it should be fine. So that's how I disagree with the war on drugs. Gun control, I did my research on how that doesn't work because, I mean, criminals will have guns based on the black market and based on the fact they won't turn their guns into firearm turn-in programs. And I also researched how these powerful guns, these big, bad, scary black rifles, don't increase crime. They allow people to protect themselves. Any gun pretty much allows people to protect themselves. I mean, if it's a real firearm with live ammunition, it will kill someone in some way to some degree. some always more powerful than others, but pretty much if it's a firearm, it kills when used by a person, of course. So that's pretty much how I disagree with gun control. Plus, I started to like guns to this day, and yeah, that's how I lost a lot of my liberal beliefs. I mean, all my liberal beliefs is that I did my research and found out, hey, liberalism doesn't work. The left doesn't work. Big government doesn't work. And then I was libertarian. So as for how I became an anarchist from libertarianism, like I watched anarchy videos and discovered, hey, minarchy doesn't work, even though it's minimal government. You just got to go full throttle to no government, to anarchy. That's how I become an anarchist. I explained that in an earlier video. So yeah, I guess I could say the reason why I was a liberal before was simply ignorance, and I guess you could say stupidity. I mean, not willful ignorance, since, you know, if I was willfully ignorant, I wouldn't ever become the anarchist I am today, or even the minarchist I was before. I mean, if you're willfully ignorant, you don't want to learn anything, thus you don't get more knowledgeable and you stick with the same stupid position you had before. I mean, I was ignorant. Nobody taught me that gun control didn't work. Nobody taught me that the war on drugs didn't work. Nobody taught me... Well, I guess some people kind of thought it was... I heard from some people, either in real life or, I guess, from TV, you know, the media, that Boston fat people around are stupid. But most of all, people didn't tell me that his ways were stupid. I mean, my dad disagreed with the war on drugs, but he's a liberal. He agrees with other crap, like gun control. Anyways, I did my own research and found out, hey, liberalism just doesn't get you anywhere. It burns down society, it increases tyranny, the government, the police state, and overall it makes people unhappy. So fuck leftism, bring on the anarchy. And I'm glad I'm an anarchist, and I don't think I'm ever going back, you know. There's no turning back now once you know the truth and decide to live upon it. Well, at the very least, believe the truth. I mean, know the truth, acknowledge the truth. I mean, I may not ever get to fix anything, but at least I can have the truth with me to look upon and know that's the way things should be. I can at least acknowledge the truth, even if I don't actualize the truth, make the truth, put into practice with anarchy. I can at least acknowledge what is true and not be, you know, deluded. Any other liberal beliefs I had? I used to think prostitution should be illegal. And then I realized, well, that just increases sex trafficking, because people can't go to legal means prostitution, they'll go to illegal means, a lot of which includes involuntary violent sexual trafficking. And that's not good, so I say legalize prostitution so there's less sexual slavery. I think it'll put a big dent in sexual slavery if you just make the damn practice legal. And it's consenting adults, so why ban that? I mean, it's sex for money, so what? It's a bit, I don't know, deviant or something, maybe, but hey, if it's consensual, hands off. So, what else did I think? That was dumb. I mean, what else did I believe in that was dumb? Okay, well, I guess I can't think of anything right now, but you get the general idea. I believed in stupid stuff, the main stupid stuff. I think I even believed in forced education for like a day, because some great English teacher, Mr. Bamey, he kind of did a presentation on it, and he made it seem good, so I believed it for a day, but then I quickly went back to not believing that stupid shit. So, I guess that's that. I mean, I'm never going back. I don't think I can go back. I mean, the truth is here to stay, and I need to stay with it, so I'm going to be an anarchist and try to find a way to make it happen, or at least acknowledge that it's the way to go. So, I guess that's all I have to say. Like, share, subscribe. Yeah, like, share, subscribe, fave. Yeah, you know what to do. Or at least what I prefer to do. Alright, bye.